Thank you. Allow me at the outset to express my congratulations and through you to your fraternal country, Morocco, on your nomination to direct our deliberations here from your high tribune and position. My delegation would all like to assure you of our full cooperation. This occasion is also one that I would like to take to pay tribute to your predecessor, His Excellency Christoph Israng, the prominent representative of Germany, who has skillfully guided our work during his term of office. Mr. Chairman, my delegation would like to associate itself with those delegations of the Africa Group and the Non-Aligned Movement in China, and we would like to bring our own national statement now. Mr. Chairman, this year has been a pivotal one for more than one reason for our organization. We are commemorating the 20th anniversary of the entry into force of the Convention. This is also a time when we'll be able to pass the baton at the highest level of our organization. And we are very much welcoming the consensual recommendation made by the Executive Council on the nomination of His Excellency Mr. Fernando Arias, the permanent representative of Spain to the OPCW. As the next Director General of our organization, we would like to wish him full success in his work. I'd also like to take this opportunity to pay tribute to the Director General, His Excellency Mr. Ahmed Uzumchu, who during his term has been able to reinvigorate our organization and promote our role as a core institution in the area of disarmament and non-proliferation. His efforts have led to the OPCW receiving the highest level of international distinction, the Nobel Prize, Peace Prize for 2013. Mr. Chairman, the standard of not using chemical weapons has this year been undermined by the recurring use of chemical weapons and chemical products for hostile purposes in Syria, Iraq, and Malaysia. Tunisia firmly condemns the use of chemical weapons wherever that may be and under any circumstances, and we call on everyone to respect international law and that the perpetrators of these heinous crimes be brought to justice. We have a shared responsibility to free the world of chemical weapons and which are being used and have been established to be used by terrorist groups. To this end, my country welcomes the full destruction of the category to Libyan chemical weapons, and this will only help to make peace and security stronger around Libya and in the entire sub-region. We also welcome the early destruction of the Russian Federation's chemical stockpiles. We hope that these two milestones will soon be followed by other states parties who will help us to definitively free the planet from any type of chemical weapon. Mr. Chairman, we are in the last curve before the home stretch to the fourth review conference, which should take place at the end of 2018, and which will allow us to evaluate our actions towards implementing the Convention over the last two decades and will allow us to see where we are going in the future. We therefore welcome the concentration of discussions taking place within the open-ended working group on the future priorities of the organization under the chair of Mr. Bruce Cohen from the South Africa and Madam Sabine Nolke from Canada. These open-ended working groups are participative and interactive so as to feed into the work of our next review conference. My delegation also would like to support the chair of the open-ended working group on terrorism, His Excellency Momar Diop, the permanent representative of Senegal, and the chair of the SWG on non-state actors, Her Excellency Madam Maria Teresa Infante, the permanent representative of Chile, for their joint efforts, which they've been deploying in these two working groups. The challenges having to do with chemical terrorism and the acquisition and manufacture by terrorist groups of chemical weapons means that we must identify the appropriate measures that will help us to prevent this threat as well as to face it in accordance with the provisions of the Convention. Mr. Chairman, Tunisia sees the future of the OPCW as being one of an organization that understands the evolution of chemistry and technology, that looks out for any challenges for the reemergence of chemical weapons and of chemical terrorism, as well as to make sure that we are operational in our full mandate in an unstable and ever-changing environment. The foundation of this enterprise, as well as any future enterprise, is obviously the CWC. The OPCW needs to make sure that we have the resources and the mechanisms so as to be able to continue to see a transfer of expertise and know-how as well as knowledge. To this end, we are very satisfied with the decision that was adopted at the Executive Council and 86th session having to do with rehiring the inspectors. For us to remain fully operational when faced with these new evolutions in the world, the organization must also have a permanent on-site deployment in the regions of the world, and we must also have a one-time rapid response teams which can work anywhere in the world without duplicating any of the activities carried out by the centers of excellence. A similar policy must take place having to do with enhanced cooperation with the OPCW and the national authorities. We must see growing cooperation among the various stakeholders in the industrial, scientific, and academic spheres, and the development of synergies among state and non-state actors. We have to see coordination and effective coordination, as well as deployment of emergency assistance of the OPCW in zones that have been affected by chemical attacks and incidents. We have to see the growing mobilization of financial resources from donors, and we must be able to follow through with forward-looking policies having to do with chemical terrorism. We must also work together with the regional actors so as to be able to effectively implement our approaches and initiatives. Mr. Chairman, I would like to ask that this declaration be distributed as an official document of the 22nd Conference of States Parties, and thank you very much.